Ahoy, ye mateys! Today I would like to share with you a ladder match I played against Stormy Quentin Berger. Quentin has a pretty notorious reputation in the pirate PvP community. There have been numerous videos made about him, and there are even videos that start by saying, "How to beat Quentin!" Quentin plays Witch Doctor, and he has all the most powerful tools in a Witch Doctor's arsenal, including the Fall Champion weapon with the trees, the Beastmaster banner, bar with the beast summons, and it isn't just that his equipment is really good, it's also that he's a really strategic thinker. So I was very honored to have the opportunity to fight him. We are going by the central rules. Pirate 101 Central is one of the biggest fan sites of this game. They have a PvP ladder that is open from August 1st through December 31st. And for playing in the ladder, players have the options of using one of these three: Central Rules, No Rules, or Create Their Own Rules. So Quentin was kind enough to accommodate my request to play by Central Rules, which is that he cannot use Scratch's 50% and 100% mojo buffs, and he also can't use Angry Orchards, which is the tree summons. Now, I've actually played, I believe, 3 or 4 matches against him on my Swashbuckler. He beat me more times than I beat him in the Buckler versus Witch matchup, but the really interesting thing is that I faced him twice on my Privateer and I actually won both times, which is unusual because I usually lose to Witch in ranked. But I think the main reason is that he's restricted by the central rules, and also since it's a ladder match, I was able to set for him beforehand. So the first time we played, I used a March, Emmett, and Bonnie. It's basically an anti-summons team, so we basically just patiently destroyed his scorpions and everything that he threw at us. And then toward the end of the match, I had Emmett use the slows aggressively to kind of push forward and eliminate his units one by one. So that was how I won the first match. For the second match, he actually tried a totally different strategy, not the classic summon strategy, but as you'll see, something completely different. And that's another fun thing about playing ladder matches, is that because you know exactly who you're facing, you can try different setups each time. So yeah, I dare say it was a pretty fun experience for both of us. We both use teams that you don't traditionally see in ranked. I hope you enjoy this video!
Interesting. That's the longest range wand in the game. And the rest are, I'm gonna say, interesting choice. Okay, so here's what I'm wearing. This is just my regular ranked set. I'm going to try a team I've never used before. See how it goes. Okay, I'm actually gonna use Gracie Conrad. The idea is that in the beginning, when Gracie can help protect the team with her Hold the Line and her Mine and her Golem minion, and then in the late game, if I can keep her alive, she has Witch Hunter, so I can just put her next to Quentin and pressure him that way. I don't know how well this will work. Oh, interesting! He's bringing... Oh my goodness, he's gonna rush me! He has 2 Swashbucklers! And Nozika!
Dang, you have a super aggressive team!
Okay, wait, Swashbucklers have low health, so I need to do this right away.
Man, that's an unusual team for sure.
better than having red like last time. Yeah, I flawless him last time. Haha. Okay, so I have repel 3 and hold the line 2, and Gracie also has hold the line 2. So Emmett has Overwatch 3 and double tap 2 for the summons, and March has repel 3, blade 2, relentless 2 for the summons, and she also has a dispel magic card which can help me if Quentin decides to use his reduced spell power card on me. So, what is your range now with the Mojo Storms? Can you see pretty much across the entire board? I'm actually not sure, because I don't mean which dog. 8! Oh my goodness. Dang. Scary. Not gonna lie, that is really scary. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and... Yeah, he's actually not gonna, just do the summons this time. He's actually gonna send his swashbucklers in. Okay, I'm gonna shield myself because I am my team's main healer. And, Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so Nausicaa 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Nausicaa cannot reach my team unless she uses her long charge. And Contessa can reach, but in order to take full advantage of his swashbuckler's damage, he needs to have them hide first. So let me see. Oh, I have another big guns actually. I'm gonna put them on the bucklers, and I guess summon the golem? Why not? This is very unusual, because usually I wait for him to summon stuff against me, not the other way around. The reason he's going for March, I think, is because he knows that she has both the Dispel Magic card and she's also my biggest damage unit. Huh. Okay, now he's going for Gracie. Okay, he used Kenpo's heal. Oh man, I might need to, let's see. No! Don't destroy my golem! No! That was short-lived. Oh man. R.I.P. Clockwork Golem. Okay, I'm gonna heal my team. And have them move up, I guess? Because the thing is, he has that Witch Doctor ability that can increase the range of his units. So, at any time, he could send, like... Huh. Okay, you know what, I'm gonna block Nausicaa's way like this and have March approach. So then he has to reposition Nausicaa if he wants to send all three of them after like March. Okay, he's gonna use another long distance attack on March. That's... oh, okay, that reduces her... oh my goodness, okay, he's gonna use Contessa's hide. Alright, well in that case, we can simply delay Contessa. So I'm gonna have Emmett use his slow on Contessa, and I'm going to block their way, and have my units retreat. Yeah, I see. His plan is to assassinate March 1st. Okay, so now Contessa has a range minus 3, so her normal range is 6. She now has a range of 3. Kenpo, even though has a really short range, he could increase Kenpo's range. Or he could also use it on Contessa, we'll see. Oh no, I made a mistake. Nausicaa can reach March. But March can also defend herself with Repel against Nausicaa. Okay, that was lucky. He didn't break that barricade. Lucky for me, I mean.
So then, Kenpo has to hide before he can approach if I position Emmett there.
And then this side, I'm protecting this side with my repel, so Emmett is guarding that side. Contessa can still reach March, unfortunately. But I don't think it kills. Like, it will do 1.8k, the backstab. And if she gets a relentless, it does like 2k. Okay, he's giving Contessa Veiler's armor. Huh, he's not going for it. Oh, I think he really wants Kenpo to back Contessa up. Okay. Well, I guess we can... In that case, we can just continue to retreat then. Two more rounds of that? Yeah, March actually cannot run out of range. But we can make it so that, Kenpo cannot back them up. Yeah. Okay, let's do that. That was a really smart move by him to use the reduced movement range on March in conjunction with Contessa's hide and backstab combo. Yeah, Kenpo cannot safely approach. I don't understand. Oh, you know what? I think he might use the reduced spell power on me the same turn. That would make perfect sense. Well, my will buff wore off, so let's do that. Maybe, I don't know, maybe he also just really wanted me to use up Emmett's slow on Contessa. March might die. Oh, that was smart. Don't relentless. Oh my gosh. That was actually... Dang, that was lucky for me. That Contessa didn't relentless. Dang. Okay, I know the pet has webs. Wait, can March move? Or will the pet? Okay, I got an epic heal. I actually don't know if I if March can live. Okay, if we use up Contessa's first strike. Oh, okay, March was able to safely retreat. Yeah, I was afraid of the... Okay, if Contessa comes this way, she will have to deal with both my repel and March's. So... And if she comes this way, then she'll be stopped by my hold the line. Kenpo is approaching as well. But he has yet to use his hide and attack combo. Okay. He put a fort on Mazika. Is my Gracie dead? Come on. Oh my goodness. Okay, Kenpo is hiding. This is bad. Oh man. Emmet can reduce Nozika, but... Yeah, I think this is the best I can do, unfortunately. Okay, Nozika has reduced weapon power for 2 turns. Contessa can still hit, but her biggest damage combo is no longer a threat, so Kenpo is the big threat now. Okay, he's healing Nozika. Oh, I landed my repel. That was lucky. I also got a Relentless. Emmet also landed his Overwatch. Oh, my March might be dead. Let's see. He blade stormed on me! No, don't. Oh my gosh. March is the greatest tank ever. March is the greatest tank ever. That was ridiculous. Well, I guess we should, we have to heal March. Yeah. Yeah, can you chain him down? I believe in you, March. I believe in you! Yeah! With the zeal, that was... yeah. So I can't believe it. I'm gonna heal March again, I guess, and then, oh, the sneaky pet is so annoying. Wait, what? Did I not click that on March? Thought I clicked March? That was weird. might have cost me my unit. Yeah, March is gone. Huh. All right, well, no, I mean, I meant to use my revive on March, not on Gracie. Oh well. Oh man, that's the mojo storm. Yeah, I think I have to do this. Can use a crit buff. Hopefully I draw more heals soon. I know I have used 2 revives so far. I have 1 more revive and a rally. 2 more team heals. Yeah. Okay, he switched targets then for Emmett. I didn't draw my heals, unfortunately. So, we'll have to do this while we still have the crit buffs up. Oh man, I might lose Emmett now. No. Oh man. He got this one. Actually though, let me see. Are his units next to each other? Yeah, they are. And they're both in low health too, so... yeah, let's just have them kill each other. Okay, now Nausicaa's still alive, but if... because if Contessa lived, then I can defend myself with Repel, but Nausicaa can shoot me from a distance. Oh, he's gonna heal her back up. Oh man, but I have to kill these skeletons first. Yeah, I have to, unfortunately. Can I crit?
I'm almost at max health now. Actually, I don't need to fort this early. I can just hit this one and then the other one will die when it approaches.
Can he see me through the barricade? Nope. Okay. Yeah, I made the right decision to wait one round to fort.
How did that barricade not break?
Oh, I can actually hit him. Yeah, and I have my fighting fervor and discipline, why not?
He's right open, right there.
If he does anything witchy, I have Witch Hunter. I also have Soul Shroud, so if Nausicaa chains me, then I can Soul Shroud on him. Kinda sad that my assassin didn't critical though. Oh man, I have to shield. Yeah, I think I have to because Quentin can reduce my spell power pretty soon. Yeah. Hold on a second, did he bring the Terracotta? No, he didn't, so those were his only summons. Yeah, he didn't bring the scorpion staff. I see, his plan was really just to use the offensive companions against me. Oh man, I knew it. He's gonna heal Nausicaa. Oh, I have to kill her. I have a sneak attack somewhere? Oh, wait, hold on. I have this. And I still have my crit buff up, so let's do that. Can I- Oh, thank god. Thank you for critiquing. She still has some health left, so, let's see. Yeah, so I need to finish with a melee hit. He still has some smaller summons, like the Bone Drake and a couple of smaller ones, but yeah. Oh, he purged. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Oh man. Oh, and if I hide, he can just trigger my Witch Hunter. Yeah, I have to fort again before I can go for Nausicaa. I know he also has like a Mojo Blade on him. See, now I'm in kind of a tough spot because if I finish killing Nausicaa, then he can prevent me from healing effectively for like 5 rounds, which is a really long time. But if I heal, then he can just continue to pressure me with Nausicaa. Okay, he's gonna shield himself. I think I am actually going to go for the heal first because I don't want to die. yeah, and then I'm gonna finish off Nausicaa. Yeah, I'm gonna heal first. Oh, that was a pretty close match. Yeah, that's the reduced spell power. Okay. Hopefully I get a Relentless on Nausicaa. Okay, I didn't need a Relentless. Phew, okay. I sometimes forget just how much my pirate can do because I usually rely on my companions to do damage for me. Oh, that's smart. That reduces my criticals. Yeah, I'm just gonna continue standing next to him, I guess. Then as soon as my fort runs out, I'm gonna put on another one. Oh. Okay, that's the Skeletal Corsair. Alright, I'm gonna fort again. Let me see, how many shields does he have? Because I know you used a fort on Nausicaa earlier. And he used a fort on Contessa too, I believe. So, yeah, he doesn't have that many defenses left. And he also used one of the Veiler's armors. I don't think I should use my Brutal Charge right now. I should save it, because if he runs, then I want to... Huh, but hold on. His range is the same as mine. Nah, actually, let's put on a will buff. Oh, but he does have the teleport spell. Yeah, I think I should save that for when he's closer to dying. Okay. You put on a will buff to counter mine? Oh, that Skeletal Corsair is gonna be really annoying. No crits, oh well. I did still have the Mutineer's Grasp on me, so that's alright. Okay, I think that's a Triton Song. Yeah, I'm gonna have to just keep using guns instead. Because I know that a Triton Song does not protect against guns. Oh, I got a Relentless. Basically drinking each other's souls. Okay. I think I have to heal because he's gonna reduce my healing again soon. Then I have to shield again. Oh yeah, that's the reduced spell power. Alright, shield again. Oh, that one lasts 4 more rounds. All right. Honestly, this match might just come down to criticals. Okay, he teleported, so I'm gonna brutal charge. Glad I didn't use it earlier. Then I have the sneak attack to finish. Nope, didn't critical. Can I relentless? Oh, glancing blow went critical. Didn't relentless, but it's alright. Okay, he's countering my crit buff. Does this kill through? No, it won't kill, because he has 25% and... but if I get lucky, I might get a relentless, which should kill, so let's just go for it. Oh, I got it. Oh man, that's so close. That's so close, oh my gosh. Oh man. That was my last fort, so... Well, what if I hide? Would that work? Okay, let's hide, because he could choose to trigger my Witch Hunter, but then I would get double the weapon power and hopefully a relentless. Huh, why did my... Weird, okay. I don't understand. How come no witch... How come... My Witch Hunter didn't go off. Okay, well, I understand I had reduced spell power, but he could kill me with the Mojo Blade, so I have to do this. Oh, I see. He saved all of his Jobu cards for the late game. That's really smart. Thankfully, only one more round of reduced spell power, and then I can use my last big guns. And I do also have two heals left. Maybe the Witch Hunter didn't go off because it was an area spell and he targeted a square other than me. Maybe that's how it works. I'll have to test it later. That's the Mojo Blade. Oh, that's so close. Is the summon gonna kill me? Oh my goodness. 300. 316, that's not enough. I'm gonna heal then. Does he have another, like, big attack on him? Like a Soul Reaver might kill me? I don't know. Or a Mojo Storm if it goes critical. Okay. Oh my gosh. $477. Okay, can I please get a relentless? And then the big guns should finish him unless I die this turn. Oh, okay. Dang, that was so close. GG.
So, I hope you enjoyed this little window into central ladder matches. If you're interested in participating in this kind of match, all you need to do is create a central account. And there is a thread in the tournaments and ladders section that explains the rules and how to join the ladder. Yeah, I really hope to see more of you in the central ladder. It's really fun to be able to meet, you know, all sorts of people who are active in this game and just try out different strategies in a low-risk environment. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.